Right, so what are we at now?
Hello, Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Finding that deviant was far from easy. You showed great skill in your investigation. But you knew deviants could be unstable. You should have been more cautious.
I thought I could make it talk. It was a judgment error.
Never mind. I'm sure you'll be more careful in the future.
In the future, I shall.
The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I would define him as dysfunctional. He obviously has a personal situation impacting his professional behavior and seems to have no interest in the investigation.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Tensions in the Arctic are
a lot I could do here.
Okay.
Apparently with no damage or casualties.
You're still here? I thought your assignment was over.
It's just been extended.
Hank's gonna be overjoyed to hear that. You were right about that android.
Alright.
It's been quiet in the cell all night. Scheduled for transfer today.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before.
If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
How about we explore a little bit more?
Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Lieutenant Anderson, this is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. It's almost noon, and I'm waiting for you at the office. It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus.
There you go.
Hank! In my office!
I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way. I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick.
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off. You are a police lieutenant. You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth.
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel. This conversation is over.
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitching. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I wonder whether Lieutenant Anderson is really the best person for this investigation.
Hey, I don't need a machine to tell me how to handle my men, okay? So get the fuck out of my office.
Have a nice day, Captain.
That didn't go well at all.
I get the impression my presence causes you some inconvenience, Lieutenant. I'd like you to know I'm very sorry about that. Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
Oh.
Come on, man, you fella.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to.
Okay, we got him back up now.
A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah, there is one.
Guess we gotta stay positive.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah, too long.
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have murdered a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. Shouldn't let your personal situation hamper the investigation, Lieutenant.
You don't know what the hell you're talking about. So why don't you just run your program and shut the fuck up?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant? I'm sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that killed the guy last night. It's been sighted in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Well, that didn't go well at all. Back at the motel, so what is your plan now?
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
So it wasn't a nightmare?
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How about a nice warm bath? And then we can go out and try to get you something to eat. What do you say? Okay. I'll run you a bath.
Try white. Let's see what black looking like. here and move that too.
You're pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
Your bath's ready.
The victim's name was Todd Williams, an unemployed man from Corktown. According to initial reports, he was shot by his android, an AX-400. The android fled the scene, and a police search is now in progress. Reporting live for Channel 16 News, I'm Josh Douglas.
You had no choice. He would have killed me if you hadn't stopped him. What are we gonna do?
Yeah, but how you gonna tell them that?
And the police are looking for us now.
I'll go with Android.
That android yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. Could be worth a try. We can't change the past, Alice. But we can decide the future. We're gonna pull through, and soon all this will just be a bad memory. Finish getting ready. I'll go out and find some food for you, and then we can get going.
So we're going to go get breakfast.
Lieutenant Anderson, Detroit Police. Looking for a female android robbed a store down the road last night. You seen anything?
An android? No, I don't think androids here.
Have you seen anyone that looks like this?
Fuck. I knew there was something weird about her. She came in last night. She was dressed normal, you know? There was no way I could tell.
Is it still here?
Yeah, probably. Room 28.
Thank you.
Well, this can't turn out good.
You wait in the car.
You're going to need me, Lieutenant. I know more about androids than you do.
Listen, I'm tired of you talking back to me. You're a machine, so shut the fuck up and do what I say.
All I want is to accomplish my mission. I'm sorry if that upsets you.
You want to see the end of your mission? Stop busting my fucking balls. It's gone.
That was close.
Fuck, that's them. Hey, stop! Police!
Which way did it go?
That way. They're headed for the train station.
Really now?
They're over there!
Shoot, we need it alive!
Oh, fuck! That's insane!
I can't take that chance.
Now you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor. That's an order.
Damn, I don't know what to do. Oh, crap.
Sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have
existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
Find Jericho!
found what I was looking for. I just synced it. Okay. On to the next one. All right, let's see if we can make this jump. Got it. Let's execute. Just like we planned it. Third one yet. Look like he didn't make it. Oh, there you go. There we go. Execute. Like so. There we go. You can do it. Who the man? Look for this way yet. Not a dead robot. There we go, right here. Lined up just right. Be going that way. We go. Dude just gonna jump. They should have installed some lights. That's locked. death lock too. And what was that? Shall we follow?
Jericho,